out of waste. So there are so many amazing streams of opportunity to start and build businesses. And green infrastructure and CSO is truly it.
And when we first started talking about this with the city and inviting them into our meetings and conversations, I think that they are, and I can't say that we have had a direct effect on that, but I do know that now they are really behind an integrated plan, and it has grown in that sense over the past few years.
What was the organization you said we're creating the community compost thing?
The one from Cleveland?
Oh, are they not local? I don't know, but you said you partnered with a composting group.
Oh, okay. Summit Reworks.
Okay.
They are the Summit County's kind of recycling authority. So they're the ones that have, they provide the bins for our curbside. You know, they get grants to do that sort of thing. And they provide the hazardous waste drop off the stove. Okay. They do programs like that. Education on that. Yes?
About 4 or 5 years ago, I was in Ithaca, New York, and up again. They're a very progressive group. Every restaurant you go into has compostables, trash, recyclables, and the trash is always the least cool with all, you know. I was just wondering, is that more of a cost to the business? You know, does somebody come and pick up that compostable stuff? You know, I was wondering, you guys just brought up that compostable business. How can the businesses do it in an affordable way so that, you know, it's just easier for them to store things in the dumpster?
Right.
It's actually more cost.
It's more cost. Right. You have to pay to haul away. Where if you recycling and finding these different avenues where there's value in that stream.
That's what I was wondering. Is it actually more cost beneficial for a business to take that extra effort?
It is, but
most
of the areas downtown, there are plenty of trash cans, but we don't have recycling.
Right.
Scattered about. I mean, that just blows my mind that we're in 2015 and we're not recycling on a larger scale.
I wonder if we could get some sort of media for all the restaurant owners together and say, hey, you know, it's actually more affordable to do it this way, it's more sustainable, it attracts more people. You know, I think it would be a neat thing to get them to understand.
Right.
And,
Great Lakes Brewing, you guys drink their beer. You know that they take their waste and turn it into fuel for their vehicles. Their restaurant waste. So it's a value chain for them. They absolutely understand it and know it. It takes people who see the value. It takes people who see the value to have a business opportunity to do that. So that's Gaines is trying to show people there is value in that. So it adds a cost, just like energy is a cost, waste is a cost to a business. And they can, you know, if you get find ways to manage that, then you have resources for other areas. Burt buildings are extraordinary buildings because if you build to a standard, then the operating cost of that building has been reduced. You know, we have several of them in the Akron area. Bridgestone is, are you guys familiar with Bridgestone building at all? Yeah, I mean, so having been in that building with and talking to the architectural firm that designed it and built it, they said the reason why they were approached by Bridgestone to build that particular level of LEED was because the employees wanted it. They wanted to be able to ride their bikes to work. They wanted to be able to recycle. They wanted to be able to do these things, and that they felt, Bridgestone felt, it was important enough to their business to retain and attract their employees to come and work there. The number one requested item for a new employee seeking employment in a corporation is the Sustainability Global Reporting Index of that organization, not the annual report. That is a transformative way of looking at sustainability. And LEED Buildings, Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design, is an extraordinary tool.
I invite you to come to the Gaines meeting on September 9th, because we will be talking about things like that, and Yolanda Walker from Summit Green Works will be there, and that will be a wonderful question.
Cool. Work on that phrasing there.
Work on what?
Okay, right over
there. Okay, I have a question. In Detroit, they have, I don't know if you're getting most familiar, it's called the Eastern Market. Yep. And it's, I don't know, a mile long almost, I think, of local farmers who bring food, I think, once a week. And it's just, I mean, it's a huge farmer's market. They have five different sheds. It's gigantic. With the closing of the Interbell, I don't know if we have that type of availability of local farmers, but is that something that we could do? You talked about 5%, or all of our food comes from California. Are we able to do something like that? Would that be a project? I mean, I know you wouldn't have the answer for that necessarily, but something like that, could we do something like that?
Maybe Dan?
Yeah. Kaylee, that's a great question, and I feel that in Akron, like sustainability requires a culture change for business to start thinking about their bottom line a little bit differently. We can start thinking about how we engage our community, our real estate a little bit differently. So I think certainly the opportunity to transform the Interbelt into something that it's not currently, which is an underused roadway. But one thing I want to caution everybody about, as far as we share our thoughts with the community, is let's not say we're closing the Interbelt, because closure in Akron has a bad word or bad connotation, you know, rubber factories closing or that type of thing. What we're going to do is transform it. It's still going to be a roadway. It's still going to have access on either side of it. We have an opportunity to transform it into anything that the community can make happen. So yes, we can take that space, turn it into 20 different blocks of 20 different things on each block, which have 100 different uses going on in each. So that's, I don't know the math, what is that? 20,000 different things can happen in that area, which is now just taking a few cars through downtown today. So yes, it can be reconfigured, reconformed, transferred into a new use, and that's part of the discussion we're having with the new urbanism lectures.
Because the Northwest thought about that and had to speak about Northwest.
Our second speaker, which will be a roundtable then on the 19th of September, he was a four-time mayor of Milwaukee who started doing new urbanism things and developments in downtown Milwaukee, and he still had this highway that separated the waterfront from downtown. So they looked at actually kind of an interbelt situation where it was this big barrier of a highway where they actually removed that, put in development, put in parkland, re-engaged the riverfront with the downtown, did these types of things that were highly successful and really transformed Milwaukee. So we have this opportunity going forward to transform downtown Akron into what we don't know what it'll become, but we can all get in on it and make it happen. So that's what Northwest has experience on. He also did it with a rail line. They managed 28 acres of rail line. Turn that into a new development in Milwaukee. So these are great opportunities. They're not closures, they're openings. You know, we're opening up a huge expanse of opportunity in downtown Akron.
Cool.
Well, thank you very much for coming today. October 6th, and Dave Rich from Community Health Center will be coming to speak to us. And I just wanted to share my experience with the Gaines organization. I've been going not to every meeting, but it's almost a year. It'll be a year in about November, December. And it's really opened my eyes. Definitely not the greenest person on the planet or anything like that, but it's really opened my eyes to just different ways to live sustainably, different projects, teaming up with people. We have a really great opportunity that stemmed from the Shipping Container Store in Better Lock back in May. that will hopefully bring something exciting, which I'll tell you about later, but just neat opportunities. So I would really recommend coming to the next meeting, because we really do need to implement some new things here in Akron, and we're able to do those things. So I guess that's it. I guess I hope you'll join us at our next meeting next Wednesday at 5:30 in the Musica Complex, and also the next Breakfast Club on October 6th. Everybody have a great day. Thanks for coming today.
Thank you.